regreso aquí en Auto 060. Y vamos ahora a pasar a un tema muy importante, que es la seguridad en los autos. Todo este tipo de información que abunda en el internet y que a veces puede resultar quizá un poco confusa, porque a veces hay como un exceso de información y que no toda la gente la puede digerir. So we're going to switch back to English because we have Diana Duque Miranda. Although she speaks Spanish perfectly, let's do this in English. Diana, how are you, Diana?
I'm doing well, Javier. How are you?
Excellent. Thank you very much for your time again. And we haven't talked in a while. And this really caught my attention because we see all these reports and studies and surveys and everything. And apparently some of these, at least some of them, don't mean too much to consumers, right?
Yeah, exactly. Well, you know, people worry about government's actions and their impact on consumer behavior. And we recently conducted a survey on the website among our users to understand if they were aware of the National Highway Traffic Association's furlough and the impact that it had basically on them as consumers. And what we found is that many people are just not aware. 82% of them were saying they really had no idea that it had an impact on them.
Yeah, and some people don't even know what NHTSA stands for to begin with, I will say.
Exactly. Exactly, and we actually, during the survey, you know, explained to them exactly what the agency does, the fact that they process complaints of vehicle defects, they issue safety recalls, and they conduct the crash tests and the ratings. And, of course, after we told them about it, they report that, yeah, I'd be very concerned about it. But before, you know, we kind of educated them about it, they weren't aware and, you know, didn't feel it was much of a concern for them.
Yeah. So for people who still don't know what NHTSA is, the National Highway Transportation and Safety Administration, which is a part of the Department of Transportation here in the U.S., and as Diana was saying, like, they conduct a lot of tests and a lot of things, and actually some people don't even know that they can call them and they can start an investigation, right? And that's how some recalls become true. Finally, they give a report, right?
Exactly. I mean, they rely heavily on consumer complaints, and that's how they are made aware of some vehicle defects, and then it is that agency that issues the recall.
Yeah. So just to make it clear, I mean, these studies and this crash test that they do at the NHTSA are, like, really, really important because they really make a difference when you get into an accident. And so it's not that the information is not important. It's like maybe we are not doing a good job about making it clear for the audience, right, and consumers. I don't know. I mean, what's your opinion on this?
No, I completely agree. I think that people are aware of safety recalls, and I think maybe people have the misconception that is the actual auto manufacturers that are issuing those. But is this agency that really requires them and forces them to do so? And so the agency conducts a very important job for consumers. And even though we found in our survey that consumers are not aware of it, you know, they do say that after they are informed about it, it is going to have an impact. So even, you know, a small impact on their decision of when to buy a car, the fact that, you know, these things are not going on right now. We have about 25% of the respondents to the survey saying that it would have some sort of impact on their purchasing of a vehicle in the next few months.
Yeah. And the other thing is that we in the media, and I'm going to take some blame on this too, because, I mean, I'm part of the media, we tend to report everything that is bad, and then we don't report as much what everything is good. And this is the case with the Toyota sudden acceleration thing, recall, that when it happened, everybody was doing stories about that. And then, like, a few weeks ago, there was a final decision on that, and they said Toyota was not at fault at that, right?
Oh, yeah, exactly. I mean, it's the negative news that really gets the headlines, right? But I think there are safety recalls, you know, all the time that the agency puts out, and some of them may not impact safety very strongly, but they're all very important. So the agency does conduct a very important service for consumers.
Yeah. And people should be really aware of these recalls, especially when they buy in a used car, I would say, because if the car has been included in a recall and it hasn't been paid attention or, like, been fixed, or at least have taken a look at it, it can be a really big problem, right? And like actually dilute the value of the car that you're getting.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we have another survey that we conduct on an ongoing basis on the site where we ask about what are the most important things to you when you're shopping for a vehicle. And safety over the past 3 months has been second only to durability and reliability. So safety isn't a very important issue, obviously, for consumers, even if it's not, you know, top of mind immediately when they're shopping. So it is very important to stay in touch with these recalls and for the media to make an effort to make sure people are aware.
Yeah. So Diana Duque Miranda from Kelly Blue Book, you also conducted in this survey some other aspects that that are important in people's minds to make the decision. So what are the positive things? I mean, I see people are getting a little bit more optimistic about the economic situation here in the United States.
Yeah, that was quite interesting. We find that about a quarter of the people responding to the survey are feeling like the economy will either remain the same, and then about 36%, that it's going to become much or slightly better. So about 40% of the people have an optimistic view of the economy in the coming months. So that's really great news. And among those people who say that the furlough, the midst of furlough, is going to have an impact on their decision, some of them are actually saying, close to 10% of them, that they're going to go out and buy a car in a hurry, because they are not quite sure what kind of impact this is going to have on interest rates and loans. And so they're actually going to go hurry up and get a car before things change.
Yeah. And I guess it's a good sign for the industry because, I mean, like we're seeing like record sales every month from almost everybody, every manufacturer.
Yeah.
So I think that optimism by the consumers is going to help with that too. And in going into that, Diana, Kelly Blue Book also launched recently another service to make the shopping experience much easier and like more informative for consumers. Can you talk about that, please?
Yeah, absolutely. This is a new feature on Kelly Blue Book that just recently, just this week, launched nationally. We've been testing it in a couple of markets, and it's now on national. So if you visit KBB.com, you will see the new car transparency feature, and it really shows, it gives you guidance on what you should expect to pay for a vehicle, what the fair market value should be. It's kind of like a traditional gauge that you would see on the dashboard of a vehicle, like a gas gauge, and it sort of goes from the left to the right. Getting all the way to the right would be kind of like a red bar that would indicate maybe that pricing is way too high, and somewhere in the middle would be the green bar that indicates that is a fair, what you should expect to pay for a vehicle and the fair market value in your area. So it's a very visual, easy way to see the information and get exactly a good understanding of the price that you should be paying for that vehicle.
Yeah. And Diana, in the next segment, we're going to have a colleague talking about the question of should I buy, should I lease? And there's tools also here in that aspect of the purchase decision, like making it easier for people to decide on that, like leasing against purchasing a car?
Yeah, there are other features at KBB.com that sort of show you what you should expect to pay on a monthly basis for a vehicle and may show you the differences between a new vehicle versus a leased vehicle versus a used vehicle. So that would make it, you know, a little bit easier and provide you some more information towards making that decision.
Yeah. And in general, that's, Kelly Blue Book obviously is a great destination for people to, as people say, do the homework before going to the dealership, right? So how long do you think in average will take somebody to go and do the research?
Well, you know, it can be very quick, or if you know specifically maybe what brand, what model you're looking for, or you could really go in there and spend a lot of time looking at a variety of models and brands, and really understanding what consumer reviews are, what our experts at Kelly Blue Book have to say about specific vehicles. So there's tons of content and tons of data if time is what you have and want to spend on researching it. But you can also do it very quickly if maybe you've already narrowed down your choices and your options and know exactly what you want to get.
Yeah, and more importantly, your budget, right? Because you don't want to.
Yeah, that's very true.
Yeah, you don't want to go there.
Very
so
true.
People have some expectations sometimes, and they want to go and like buy the finest car. So, Diana Duque Miranda from Kelley Blue Book, thank you very much as always for the great information. So, and KBB.com, right, to find out about all this great information.
Yeah, exactly. Whatever you need to know about a new vehicle, even a used vehicle, visit KBB.com, and you're sure to find the information.
Thank you very much, Diana, and see you soon, maybe at the LA Auto Show.
Awesome. I will see you there. Thanks, Javier. Have a great day.
Thank you very much. Ahí tenían a Diana Duque Miranda de Kelley Blue Book hablando sobre los dos temas importantes de esta semana, que fue cuán importantes son los resultados de las pruebas de seguridad que hace el gobierno y esta nueva herramienta para hacer más fácil la tarea a la hora de comprar un auto. Y hablando de esto, en el siguiente segmento vamos a hablar con una colega que nos va a explicar las ventajas y desventajas, o los mitos, mejor dicho, a la hora de hacer un lease para un auto nuevo. Así que no se vayan, esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota, y como siempre, gracias a DJ Cafa ahí en los controles, y recuerden visitar nuestra página de facebook.com/auto060, y también para el resto de la programación de Cristina Radio Network, facebook.com/Cristina Radio. Yo soy Javier Mota, esto es Auto 060.